Hi, my name is Kevin Backhouse. I'm a security researcher at Semmle. During the summer of 2018, I found a vulnerability in Apple's XNU operating system kernel, which enabled me to crash any Mac or iOS device that was connected to the same Wi-Fi as me. I found that vulnerability with a QL query, but this video is not about that query, but about how I use QL to figure out how to write the exploit. So this is the query that found the vulnerability. And it identified this function called icompError as being possibly vulnerable. But what I needed to figure out was whether I could get malicious data into this parameter M. So I used QL to do that. So I started out with this simple query here, which basically just said, I just want the sync to be that parameter of icompError. And as the source, it just said anything, because I didn't know anything about icompError or how to reach it. So I ran that query and finds quite a lot of results. But what I noticed looking through these results is that quite a lot of them come from a function called ipinput. And that's very interesting because ipinput is where all incoming IP packets come into the computer. So that was worth exploring further. So what I did was I modified the query to say, well, I'm only interested if the source is in the function ipinput. And so running that query reduces the results down quite a bit. But what I also noticed looking through some of these results is that some of them go through a function called ipforward. And although that may be a possible exploitation path, it looked more difficult to me. So I wanted to remove those results from the query. So I made one final iteration of the query where I added an extra predicate called isBarrier just to say, if the path goes through IP forward, then I'm not interested. And so with that restriction in place, it reduces the number of results. And now I get this path here, which starts out in IP input and then goes through a function called IP do options. And then you see that if it hits a bad case, then it calls icompError. And so this was all the information that I needed to figure out how to write the exploit. All I had to do was create a malicious TCP packet that had some invalid IP options on it. And that would trigger this code path and hit the bug in icompError. Thanks.